OP 46, unintentional injuries among in-school adolescents in Sri Lanka, by presented by Dr. A.O.P. Galagi, together with S.A. Vikramasinghe, S.J. Senanayake, M.P. Kumukge, and S.R.H.P. Gunawardana, S.C. Vikramasinghe, A. Lukubalasurya, N.S. Gunawardana, R. Peeris, and C.V. Madhumaheva. Okay.
Good afternoon to you all. I'm Aruni Galage. Today I'm going to present you about unintentional injuries among in-school adolescents in Sri Lanka. Unintentional childhood injuries are a global public health problem. It is also considered as a major cause of death and disability all over the world. In Sri Lanka, we have around 6.1% adolescents from the total Sri Lankan population, out of which about 70% are schooling. Global School-Based Student Health Survey was conducted for the second time in Sri Lanka in 2016. The objectives of this study was to estimate the incidence and to identify the associated factors of unintentional injuries among school-going adolescents between ages 13 to 17 years using the most recent data from the GHHS survey. The GHHS methodology was developed by WHO with the technical assistance from the CDC. This is a cross-sectional study done in the government schools among students of grade 8 to 12. We used the final sample size as 3,125, and we used two-stage cluster sampling design. In the first stage, we chose 40 schools, and in the second stage, the classes were selected as clusters. We used a self-administered standard GHHS questionnaire after cultural adaptation and translation to Sinhala and Tamil. The questionnaire had 71 questions in 11 modules, and there were 3 questions regarding injuries, which inquired about the type of injury, about the frequency of injury, and the cause of injury, which happened during the past 12 months of the survey. We had some additional questions to assess associations, and the associations were analyzed using bivariable and multivariable logistic regression. This is the GHHS definition about serious injury, and this is the distribution of the selected schools in the country. To compare the results, we concentrated only on the age group of 13 to 17 years, and the overall response rate was around 89%. In our study, there were slightly more females than males, and majority, about two-thirds of the population, belong to ages 13 to 15 years. Hereafter, I'll be considering it as the younger age group. And 35.8% of the population was reported as being seriously injured at least once during the 12 months of the survey. Passed the survey, and there was a significant high proportion of males being reported as injured than females. There were no significant difference between the two age categories. However, the male proportion of being injured was significantly higher than the female proportion of being injured. The most commonest type of reported injury among the study participants was cut or stab wound, followed by broken bone or dislocated joint. And cut or stab wound was the most commonest type in the younger age group, but in the old age group, it was broken bone or dislocated joint, as well as in the male group. But in females, it was cut or stab wound. When the overall data was considered, there was no significant difference between the two age groups, but males had higher proportion of injuries than the female group. When we consider the cause of injury, falls was reported as the most commonest cause of injury, which was common in the younger age group, in the old age group, as well as females and males. But there were no significant difference between the age groups, but males had high proportion of falls than the females. These were the associated factors we considered, and bivariable analysis revealed that male sex, being bullied, feeling lonely, considering suicide, current smoking, alcohol and recreational drug use, lack of parental supervision, being physically attacked and involving in a fight were associated with injuries. However, multivariable analysis revealed that only 4 factors were associated with injuries. So in conclusion, the proportion of students suffering from serious unintentional injury was found to be unacceptably high, male sex, being bullied, being physically attacked, being in a physical fight were associated with serious unintentional injury. Unintentional injury in adolescents is a major public health problem in Sri Lanka. So we recommend that every school should have a safe school policy in place and it is well monitored for implementation. The schools should conduct regular safety and hazard assessments to ensure safe environments, and the school curricula should be strengthened to help students to develop knowledge, attitude, behavior skills and confidence needed to adapt and maintain safe lifestyles. Interpersonal skills, anger management skills should be developed to prevent violence among students. These are my references. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Time for questions and comments. How do you define a serious accident in this study?
Yeah, sir, in the GHSS, they have defined a serious injury if a student misses at least one school day or requires treatment by a doctor or a nurse. Yes, madam. This has been done to because we have to compare between the two between countries. Sri Lanka has ranked among fourth commonest type country which has unintentional injuries. We have comparison studies between Malaysia and Thailand and other Southeast Asian countries. Actually, this is a Sero region study which has been done by WHO and collaboration with CDC. That's why we have taken the age group 13 to 15 to ensure the comparisons.
Now, as the risk factors, I thought that you came up with more the personal factors.
Yes,
like
madam.
Depression and
yes.
That type of thing.
Yes,
but then in the conclusion, you have said that hazard assessment in the school.
Yeah.
So I didn't see any comment on your report on the hazard risk. In
madam,
schools.
Yeah, madam, that's because the commonest cause of injury has been falls among the entire study population.
Yes.
So that has been, that's why we are reinforcing on hazard assessments at schools. Actually, it has been done at the school health survey also. The PHI goes and visits the schools and do the hazard assessments to ensure the safety at schools. Because
so
the common
is the hazard assessment report in of our schools?
We have a tool to do that, madam.
So do you know the report, I mean the results of that, the hazard risk, is it high in schools? I mean,
actually the data is not like, we have not combined the data and reported it yet. But we do assessments twice every year at schools by using PHIs.
Data was collected at school?
Usually, sir, at the Ministry of Education and Ministry of Health also, the Family Health Bureau, the school unit collects the data, and epidemiology unit also collects the data regarding these problems.
So the deaths and disabilities that prevent school attendance also include?
Sir, no. We have excluded the fatal injuries. This is only the non-fatal but serious unintentional injuries.
Not only in school, but even at home.
Yeah, it can be.
Yeah.
We took the in-school adolescents, madam, but the question
I...
Yes, that's true.
So that is a serious limitation when you say that fatal
injuries
are excluded.
Yes, we have few limitations in this study, sir. One is the recall bias. The other one is we only concentrated on the in-school adolescents, but we have about 30% of the adolescents in the country which are not schooling. So that is a limitation in our study.
We have